Hello, Internet. This is Scott with Scott's Garage, and I am privileged to be outside my garage, sitting in my 2000 GMC Sierra 1500, soon to become a project truck. Now, there is a presenting problem. It's November. Winter is coming. We've had several freezes at night. It froze last night. Now, I've been driving for about a half an hour, and the problem is this. If you look at the temperature gauge, the operating temperature of the motor is 170 degrees at the most, and that's a problem. Now, I know the reason why. The thermostat on this engine is stuck open, and we'll be changing it out. I'll show you how to do that. But I also want to talk about thermostats and what their function is and why it's important that you have an operating thermostat, and also that it be a thermostat that opens up at 195 degrees and not any cooler than that. And I'll tell you why that is so important. So I hope you enjoy this episode of Scott's Garage. Okay, this is a typical thermostat. This is not the thermostat for the GMC. It's a little bit different style, but they all kind of function the same. Now, if you look at this, here's the housing, and it was sometimes called the frame, and that's the silver part. And then below the housing, you have a couple of valves. This is the main valve, and the default is the main valve is shut until the engine reaches operating temperature. And then there's a bypass valve, which is below it. There's a spring for each, so the main valve has a larger spring, the bypass valve has a smaller spring. And the default for this is that the bypass remains open until the operating temperature reaches its mark, and then what happens is the bypass closes, the main valve opens. Now you have to kind of visualize this. And by the way, the thermostat sits in what's called a neck, and so it's just a housing that it encapsulates it. And the neck is attached either in newer engines to the water pump typically, or in older engines, the neck is attached to the intake manifold. Now, kind of visualize this, that this is sitting in the neck, and it usually is, you know, this is like the top, but you have your radiator here, and you have the upper hose, which is typically the larger hose, and then the bottom of the radiator is your lower hose, and the upper hose is the inlet into the radiator. Typically, the flow is from the motor and the water pump, and it pushes the coolant through the neck, and it reaches the thermostat, and then when it reaches operating temperature, the main opens and the flow goes then to the large hose, top of the radiator, it goes through the radiator, it's cooled, and then the coolant at the bottom of the radiator goes into the engine, so the outlet of the radiator, that's the flow, it goes into the engine. But that's typically how it works. Now the thermostat, basically this is a barrier that if the coolant is not warm enough, you turn the engine on, it's cold, that it circulates, but it reaches this point, it goes through the bypass, it goes back to the motor, and it doesn't reach the radiator. Now, as the engine heats up, the main valve opens. And you can do this if you want. You can test these, get some boiling water, and you can see this retract down, and basically it opens it so that the coolant flows, it hits the barrier, but it's now open, and it goes through that, and again, it goes into your radiator. Now, if you look at these, typically you can see stamped the bottom of the radiator of the thermostat, the temperature that this opens up. This is 195, and that typically is the best thermostat temperature. You can buy those that are like 180, and you might say, well, you want it to run cooler, so you're going to have a thermostat of 180, or you can go like a 205, or there's a different range. But I typically have found that if you think your engine's overheating, so you get a thermostat that's 180, you're solving the problem. You're not. You're simply delaying the problem by a few minutes. Now, typically, motors run efficiently at 195 or maybe 205 temperature. And if your engine's running too cold, and by the way, the coolant that flows around the motor, it's called the water jacket. And it just keeps the motor, it draws the heat out of it. And typically 195 degrees is the temperature that your fuel is automized more efficiently. And so if it's running too cool, you're not going to have as strong of a motor. And again, your gasoline not automizing correctly. So let's now change the thermostat in the GMC. Okay, the first thing we need to do is remove the air intake tube. This is a 10 millimeter right there and right there. So you take those clamps off and you can pull it loose on both ends. You need this out of the way. Okay, the next thing we need to do is drain the coolant from the radiator. And to do that, there's a drain valve, the bottom of the radiator. This one's plastic. In the older cars, it was brass, called a petcock valve. And you simply turn it counterclockwise. You can do it with your hand. You don't need a wrench or a tool. Just open it up. Please note that I have a bucket underneath to catch all the coolant. Now, the reason we do this is that the thermostat is located down here quite a bit lower than the radiator. Okay, the next thing we need to do is remove this hose. And by the way, this setup is just the opposite of what I described earlier. What I mean by that is that the upper hose in this vehicle is actually the smaller diameter hose, 1.25 inches. And the lower hose is the larger hose, 1.5 inches. A little bit confused by this, but this is how this works. And the thermostat is found in the lower hose. Now, I looked it up and the flow is still the same. However, the cooler coolant is the lower hose. The warmer coolant is still the upper hose going to the radiator. It's just that the thermostat is found on the lower hose. Here's a diagram that hopefully makes it clear what I tried to say before. The flow is still the same. The hot coolant exits the engine. It's the upper radiator hose, smaller diameter, but still the upper radiator hose, goes through the radiator, cools down. The cooler coolant exits the radiator, and the thermostat is found in the neck that is attached to the lower radiator hose. I'm used to the thermostat being attached to the upper radiator hose, but this is how it works in this Vortec engine. Okay, I removed the bracket and then the hose that is the main feed to the water pump. And the neck going into the water pump, that is where the thermostat is located. And coolant will come out as you loosen these bolts. And coolant came out when I took the hose off, but I have a bucket underneath. And you'll need a 10 millimeter. There's a bolt here and then 180 degrees around, just right below that, another one, and again 10 millimeter. Okay, so I'm simply working by myself here, and I didn't film it, but coolant came out when I cracked it. There's a little O-ring in the neck, and we should see thermostat. I think it's built in, if I remember correctly. Yeah, so this is built in. Thermostat's built into the neck. So this is what you'll need to replace. Okay, I purchased a new thermostat, identical to the old one at O'Reilly's, about $22. Here's the installation. The first thing I'm doing, first of all, is putting some motor oil on the O-ring. This will help seat the thermostat. It goes right in the groove there. Just then make sure when you put it in place that it doesn't fall down, and we'll just carefully put it in place and put the bolts in. Now I'm reattaching the lower hose, the coming from the radiator. Put it on there, and I'll put the clamp back in place. Almost done. Now I'm just reattaching the air intake hose. Okay, I started the engine, and what I'm doing now is topping off the coolant. Make sure your petcock valve is closed, otherwise you'll be draining over your driveway. So I'm using the universal 50-50 coolant. It's already pre-mixed, and again, simply topping it off. I figure I'd probably drain about 3/4 of a gallon, so just looking at the reservoir, making sure it's topped off. Okay, I have everything buttoned up, checked for leaks, and there are no leaks. I've had the engine running for about 5 minutes now. And the proof will be if the temperature has been raised. I'd like it to be 195. That would be ideal. Let's see. All right. So it is exactly where it should be. The engine is now running at 195. And that is the best. The gasoline is automized, 195 and above. And as I said before, if you are running cooler than 185, 180, there's something wrong. Your engine will not run efficiently if it's running too cool. So this is Scott with Scott's Garage. If you got any value out of this video, please hit like. If you have not subscribed to Scott's Garage, please do so. And I look forward to seeing you in another video. Have a great day.